And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
Here we go, set. Go.
Starting on the ground with Herbert. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down. Herbert now on the option. And the defense closes quickly there. He'll get maybe a yard to the 33. Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. They'll run with Herbert. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Didn't get it by much, but bottom line, got the first down. Avoiding that three and out, how vital is that on the first drive?
To me, it's like the first round of a boxing match. You know, it may not mean much right then and there, but you'd rather not lose it, right? So you want to go ahead and get it, kind of establish something early and hope it can carry through.
This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
Meanwhile, Fields' throw complete here to Kmet. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 41-yard line.
You got a mini base. One tonight.
Off play action, Fields. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. From the 50, here's Fields. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. The perennial Pro Bowler Aaron Donald gets the sack.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. Here we go on fourth down, Fields. Escaping the pressure, and he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs.
I've been going hard from the night into the daylight. Telling them all that yesterday's price is not the same price. Eating up wings for breakfast, I can tell you what it tastes like. Wake up and I see red and I still don't got no brake lights. Yeah, feeling super fly. I look in the mirror, see ambition in my eyes. Got more than one.
I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure. Try and get a big stack in my bag. Boy, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that. Try and get a big stack in my bag. Yeah, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that, big stack, big stack in my bag. It's like that, big stack, big stack in my bag.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the Los Angeles Rams. And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. Pushing his way through, and he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line. And they'll start on the ground with Hubbard. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
A quick throw complete to Chark. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44.
That was a lightning fast decision that time. He just caught it, got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately. So he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play. And immediately got to the pass.
Come on, dog. You're so scared to turn over the ball. You're scared to throw it. Bad at
his throw incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there, and it's third down and two. Here we go. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try and run for this with Hubbard. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. Young here, you can see, changing the play.
Thank you. Smack the fuck out of him, because that's what I should have did the last play. What's the bitch?
As he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss.
This man is down the head to buy the whole first quarter. God damn.
So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. Young off the play fake.
Thank you. Good time. Short
underneath to Hurst. So completion good for just three.
Keep it up.
Third and a full 10 yards. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Young on third down.
My ball.
And
that's going to be incomplete.
The contact there enough to jar that ball free.
And it brings up fourth down.
It's pretty early in the game, but they've already tried to establish him not just as a runner, but as a receiver as well. Didn't happen there, but I wouldn't be surprised at all to see him try again shortly.
He had the whole first quarter to kick a field goal.
And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance.
Charles, even as long field goals become more and more common, this is still very rarefied air. Only just over 20 field goals have been kicked from 60 yards or further, and you can add his name to the list now.
And as calm as he tried to present himself, There's no doubt there were some nerves as he lined up to attempt that kick. But once the ball was snapped,
but it's like, dang, he know where to go sitting in his 8 minute because he know what I'm finna run. Like, you know what the fuck I'm finna do. You know when that man go in motion, who finna get the ball? Like, you know what I do. And it's sad. Like, he might start to remind me of Kirk. You get so used to playing him to where he's studying what you're doing and know what to do to try to attempt to stop you. But it's funny because I still will drop 50 on his ass. Still.
They'll move him back in the backfield to make him running backs. Partner, this was much more of a tap pass.
Love
it if you're a quarterback. It's an easy completion. If you're a wide receiver, you get the easy reception and also a chance to try to make a play with your feet.
Got a man, it's Higbee complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 23 yards, the final tally.
I fix how this playbook is set up. I don't like how it plays, so I have to go searching for plays.
Hey, middle. Hey, hey.
No clue.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford.
Okay.
That'll be caught. It's Kupp. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. From the red zone now.
Sorry,
Stafford.
Okay.
He's got it. It's Higbee.
Touchdown, all them plays and didn't run the ball not one time. Even though he gave me the ball 1 minute, I tried to score in that 1 minute. But see,
3 points and take a first quarter lead. Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. This Carolina offense at the line.
From this formation alone, I know he's running the ball.
Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their
only
kicker,
other route he could be running is awesome.
Get
right
free.
Here.
Now here they'll try to do better
do well.
And find the end zone.
That's pretty
good. How
running
fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now, the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just get.
Ready.
This is a run, too.
On play action. Young.
That's. You're supposed to pick it, but I live with what just happened.
A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
Normally, you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well.
Throw it. There we go. Throw it. Thank you, stupid ass.
Back at the 4 yard line.
What you trying to do? Are you punting?
Defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite.
I don't know how to do that.
To
I don't showboat.
It's almost like a reverse.
When I score, I score. I don't really got extra shit.
And this time they take their man
running into the kicker.
Fair catch called
good
for
job.
May, but now we'll have to see about the penalty.
He's back his ball. Roughing the kick of 15 yards. So what is it? First and so I don't get it. What is it? Like, is it on me? Is it on...
Great field position.
Yeah, it gave him back the ball. See?
That is funny.
So a big break, the roughing the kicker called on fourth down.
That shit was cute. Not even on the ball because he know he can't pass it. That shit funny, bro.
The play fake. Now Young.
Why they got him so slow? Why is he so slow? Come on, bro. Good job.
Left sideline. Touchdown, Panthers. Adam Thielen.
Supposed to be my fucking ball. They called the penalty and gave the ball right back to that nigga.
Eddie Pinheiro now for the extra point.
Let No, it's cool. It's cool. It's cool. I sent them to go block the kick. Instead, he just ran into the man. It's cool. Like I said.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off.
I say you don't want anybody to call out. Be a really, really good person. Oh, man.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
This would be funny.
The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive. Now a first down throw, Stafford.
I'm in this bitch. And it's going to take less half of the time.
That's good for 28 yards.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found
him. Okay, cool. Keep staying at defense.
Stay in. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Stay in that defense, my dude.
Panther territory now. It's first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
And now a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now it's Stafford.
Just because I knew he was going to go. Come on. Incomplete.
Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Come on. Why so far? He threw, they made him overthrow the ball by a lot. Come on, bro. I'm not kicking my motherfucking field, bro. You got me fucked up. Wow, since I thought you and my opponents were worth it.
Couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Sonic and nasty bitch.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. They snap it to Stafford.
Stay down.
Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted.
Oh, he's gone. Oh, they're letting him by receivers. Oh, that's what he's done. So he just found the receiver and the running back. That's fine.
They finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase and got it done.
Still a great return and very good field position. It's a second down run with Sanders, and he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second.
Well, I know what you're trying to do. It's on Madden, let me stop it.
Here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. On the double. The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 11. Ready. Young to throw it.
Exactly. Thank you. Take it for both. And I'm going to make sure I'm going to none of your men.
Put a few extra defensive backs on the field. Give them nowhere to throw the football.
Don't go touch him.
The incompletion and get off the field on third down.
This is up and good from Pinheiro. And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. So golden field position there squandered as they can muster only a field goal.
Yeah, you were gifted a first-to-goal situation, but I have to give credit to the defense. They were brought out in a really tough situation, so give them credit for holding them to 3. That's a pretty nice accomplishment.
Tyler.
The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. But not an ideal way to end their previous drive. They threw the interception, Charles, after they had built up some momentum. They were moving the football. For this offense as they run back out here.
You're right about that.
Gaining chunks of yardage, getting first downs, really making a push for the end zone, and look like they had a nice rhythm going. Now you got to have a short memory. Focus on what came before it and get back to it.
Ball on the 30 now. Here's second down and a yard. Open man is Higbee, the tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before the
flurry of punches at you.
On first and 10, Stafford.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now a play fake it at Stafford.
Here's another one intercepted.
Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And the Panthers will take over possession here up at the 44. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with interception.
I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily. But I also wonder if it's going
to. I just compress it to who I see.
Does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Don't do too much to him. Don't try to be cute. Take it for what it's worth. You're up by six. I'll second that much.
He'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. The Rams are going to use their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
Exactly what I thought. The same shit.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense.
Not gonna touch the people this time. Back up and throw the fuck out there. Well, he gonna catch
Absolutely none of it stuffed him for a loss.
Yeah, couldn't get any leverage up front and move people.
No points though.
They're gonna stay out and
go in route to number 19. Now fake right, go left. It's so easy to see what he's about to try to do. He's about to try to take advantage of the alley.
Young, there it is. 50. Told you.
I knew it. Number 19.
As they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one.
Okay, ready?
The best thing about this is. He has absolutely nothing to do. Good luck with that. Now you're going to have to buy 10 minutes. Stupid.
The offense moving quickly to the line.
Exactly. So all I got to do is tackle him inbound.
Second down.
That's cute.
And they're knocking on the door now. As a good run there, going to take this to about the 10-yard line.
Here we go.
He pissed him. His man dropped the ball, didn't caught it. That's possible. His man dropped the ball, didn't caught it. Look at the rip. Man, you on the YouTube? Pull it back. This man dropped the ball, didn't caught it. That's. I've never seen that before.
Young takes it on the sneak, and he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown.
That's cool.
In the final seconds of the first half, and the Panthers will extend their lead here just before halftime. Pinheiro's extra point up and good, and the lead now stands at 13. So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. And solid field position here to start as they get this out to the 40-yard line.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
The final second ticks by, and that's going to do it for the first half of play. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Rams set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside, probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
50-50. Zebra.
Stop. Stafford now to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Really good coverage all over the field, and it took away his intended read and almost dared him to try for his guy out of the backfield. No surprise on that one. It doesn't connect.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Flush to his right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. He could not get rid of it, and a big-time loss there on third. The sack sets up fourth. Here comes the Rams punter now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline.
Ready up.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Running right, here's Sanders. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Ready?
Straight ahead with Hubbard. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
Well, they went back to him, but the results were similar, so I highly doubt that he'll get another opportunity here on third and long.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Young off the bootleg. A short throw hauled in by Trimble. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
Is your bitch ass really running the clock in the third quarter?
The kick by Pinheiro is good, and that will extend their lead.
I purposely kicked the ball short to give him the ball right there for him not to score. I knew he wasn't going to score, and the nigga still, that's funny. He spent more time on the kick than fucking scoring on it. Thank you, though. It's cool.
Please salvage something out of this drive. That was
told you, here's some try hard. I lose interest fast. I don't like this shit free. I'm not ever going to be mad at something that's fucking free. He's in the same two niggas. This nigga off the right and this nigga off the left. Oh, please. It's real simple what you're fucking doing. Thank you.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least.
I'm telling you, not a few more plays before I lose interest. So, yeah, I'm not yet. I'm definitely not about to try hard. This time they want to string together a nice drive. If you stop me this drive, he got it. I'm not gonna quit, but he got it. Trying to fight off this shit.
Well, Stafford.
Come on. He's sitting in the same zone. This is the funny part about it. My man, that was hard, bro. That pass wasn't even to a receiver. He threw the ball to the ground. That shit is amazing. I start losing this game after that fucking flag. That's crazy. Then he's going to come out and run the ball three times and then kick another field goal. That's first one. That's first one. Thank you. Somebody at least try to save this drive.
He might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Those are the plays this defense needs with the deficit they're facing.
It certainly is. And
nah, he fucking run. That's cool.
While they're holding up the ball carrier, can get in there and rake it and
lock it free.
They need
to
get some takeaways as well.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
I don't know if he think the clock running, but he don't know. I guess he didn't see I called the timeout. Is that all the time he taking to call a play? Yeah, that's because he think the clock running. Oh, my dog. Oh, yeah, I'm going to force him to another field goal. It's cool. They don't have to let me score, but I promise you, you know.
And that's going to leave him with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Now you're going to try to switch it up. Yeah, exactly. There you go. He's definitely not running about this thing.
Here comes Sanders on the toss run.
Let's do it. Let's get around the fucking ball. And they're
just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Take it for a goal, bro.
Terrific work there defensively. Running backs trying to get wide, get to the sideline, and they beat him to the spot.
I'm losing to this suck ass man, bro. It's cool. I'm playing frustrated, that's why I'm mad. That's cool. It's cool. Yeah, that's what I see on YouTube. It's all that he's still on the win about two touchdowns.
Field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say we should have done better there.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try,
another bad foul. He threw the ball out of each other's hands again. Good job.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also
staff is showing his ass. Good job on fighting them out of here.
In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Thank you, Cliff. Thank you, Paul. Another bad ball. Come on, man.
Come on,
like, you gotta want to throw a fucking ball. This is a lot of people coming across the middle of the field, and this is gonna bring the ball to the fucking ground again. Make it cut? Is he in that same stupid ass Plex defense? Like, that shit whack to me. There was another bad ball.
That's gonna be knocked away and incomplete.
They geared up and took the deep shot downfield, but it turned out it wasn't one-on-one coverage. Extra defenders in the area, and that one winds up incomplete.
The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10.
Come close. I know that's a good thing.
Here we go on 4th. Stafford.
Thank you. They're the same fucking defense. Here's me. Hard to ball and drop. Good job, boy.
And they turn it over.
Yeah, he's trying to football.
And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. On the handoff, running left is Hubbard. He'll get this down to 21, just on the edge of the red zone. Now a timeout called for by the defense. So, boy, that's already the third they burned here. They are out of timeouts now before we've even hit the fourth quarter. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now third down coming up.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And Young's throw there incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive. But
at least he getting downfield. They're not even letting my man get passes off. He at least in the red zone every time. And I'm holding him to field goals. This nigga is on it. Like, he in scoring range every time. I'm getting about outside of scoring range. And my man not throwing passes to the receivers. So, story of this game.
Simply stated, I think you have to look at that as a missed opportunity.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Let's try some other shit since it's in the same zone.
Set to begin.
Same zone.
Drive the
for loafing fucking Jeremy Chin.
Well, this has been a tough one for him, Charles.
There it
They've
is.
Struggled
really
there,
I'll make it cut. Thank you. That's his own beater. It's the pass play. Finally. Okay. Like we done with it this year.
Every game that's ever been played,
it's not the one anchor pass. Come on,
just talk about taking care of the football.
Last 10 balls been fucking uncatchable, but
after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball, and it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
Because I know what defense is. Not beat it very well. Make it cut. You took too long to make that fucking cut. Come on, man. I know the route. Run it. What is you doing? Can you lollygagging and fucking freelancing? Run the route, man.
Stafford on first down. Under pressure and
bullshit. That's why the fuck I had to stand there and take the sack. On your route.
The pressure from multiple guys there as they bury him for a big 9-yard loss. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19.
3, 2, 1. Thanks, dude.
Now with
out of bounds, please. Box still running. Box stop. How we doing this? I'll be in front of
them. And that'll make it 3rd and 13. And not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
That's just what I was expecting. Thank you. Come on, keep moving. Keep moving. Fuck, are you going to stop running for? Come on, dog.
Down inside the 20 at the 19. Decent gain
on
the scramble.
It's like I'm far early.
Well, there were a couple of extra defensive backs in the game, so he really had nowhere to go with the football despite his search for an open receiver.
So
he has to take off and run for it, but he comes up well short of the line to gain.
This play either going to end up in a touchdown or it's going to end up in a steal.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
They go to movement. They go to link tree. And they go to interception.
His pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Jeremy Chin picks it
off. This ball's on little direct. You don't throw it up. You gotta throw it up. That's got too much in the rough. I told you, man. That touchdown now, fuck up.
Just keep. Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense.
I'll talk to you later.
Thrown all these interceptions.
We
another test. One there.
I'm pretty much different about this 316.
Nice little spot in the postgame highlights to show this rip of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap one.
Pinheiro now to add the extra point. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Pinheiro now to add the extra point. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now.
Mm-hmm.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Now this one complete on the slant route. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. To the air again, Stafford. This one swung out to Williams. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. And quickly, they get to the line. On first down, it's Stafford. Escaping the pressure right. And that throw behind his man. He missed him. Incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break. And you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
This offense was on the move. 22. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Again, it's Stafford. Flush to his right. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. And this one dropped in the end zone. Looked like a touchdown, but not to be. And now it's fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to try and go deep again. And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. Dante Jackson picks it. And the Panthers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to seven. If we'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
And we'll see if the defense wants to stop it as they take the knee. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. He moved from your former position senior year, strong safety.
Yeah, sometimes they get you up near the line of scrimmage or you're trying to time up a blitz. You've got to get it right, otherwise that flag comes out and you just cost your team some yardage.
The Panthers down to a knee out of the victory formation. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
So jumping from his free safety spot.
That tells you how aggressive they are on defense, doesn't it? They get everyone involved. He was a little too fast on that play.
Step by me, can't do it back, keep backs on me. Name him with I keep three on me.
This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the New York Giants. Two teams have met in Super Bowl 35 down in Tampa. The Ravens and Giants are underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
56. Home it, say. Home it, say.
Up. Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he maneuvers up the middle for three.
Let's go, let's go.
And it's second down. Here's second and seven now from the 28. On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. Throwing, Jones. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. Now Jones just going to bat this forward on the jet sweep. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
And this is just a little touch pass. They send the receiver in motion, just kind of tap it forward to him. That doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down, a nice consistent game.
Now Jones. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 36. They'll look to throw again. Eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Ladybug. Here we go,
Again, he'll drop to throw. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 20-yard line. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Back to throw again. And his throw here is incomplete.
So he's every quarterback I've kicked over the long balls, bro.
I would agree with that, but if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position you have to be, you just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Jones fakes the give to Barkley.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my mother. Fucking dog. Come on, son. This man caught the ball, went back and dropped it.
And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Gano's kick is good. And Giants are off now to a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's caught. It's Flowers. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 25 yards that time. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
On 1st and 10, it's Jackson. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Devin Duvernay. 38 yards, and the Ravens have answered that early field goal to take a first quarter lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick.
Most of not the overtime ball. Good job.
In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. Maybe worse than the loss of yardage, they also lose the down. So now it's 3rd and long. Operating from the gun, Jones. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Armour-Davis. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. After the interception, here's Jackson.
That was cute. That was cute.
Throw caught by Flowers. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Play action. Now Jackson flushed out right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Many times when a play breaks down and the quarterback's moving around outside of the pocket, you're thinking, just get rid of something short. But a lot of guys are coached, think deep, take the big shot, hoping someone can get lost behind the secondary. They weren't able to connect on that one.
Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson, escaping the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
Nobody don't want to hear that shit.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. So they go play action with Jackson.
Nobody don't want to hear that shit.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Jackson will throw again. Steps away to his left. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson, a 6-yard touchdown run. And they are able to add on to their advantage.
Well, that was all Lamar Jackson all the time on that drive, both through the air and in the end with the touchdown run.
Yeah, how about him doing things a little bit on the reverse side there, Brandon, because he softened him up throwing the football and opened up the running lanes. And when he gets a little bit of a sliver, he's gone.
Man, cut that stupid-ass music off, bro. I don't want to hear that shit.
Tucker now to kick it away.
He having a party by himself. Good-ass nigga. You know what happened.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want to...
Ready to roll for the second quarter from MetLife Stadium. The Giants with the football as they've got it facing a second and long situation.
Wow, listen to this.
Looking to throw. Jones. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety.
All right, partner. Deuces wild on this sequence. Two plays, two sacks, and now 2 points thanks to the safety. Offensively, there just didn't seem to be much of a plan when they came out on attack. That led the defense create a little chaos up front and set up one of their guys to make a play and get through and record the sack.
Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line.
A bit of a jump there, CD. He breaks the line, and that'll...
Come on, man. Start the game, bro.
Yards. And you've got to stay more disciplined than that, Brandon. That's just a free gift to the offense.
Yes, sir. You'll see.
A boost here to start the drive. After the penalty, it's first and 5. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And that'll be a free 5 yards
for the offense. Just like a tennis match, that's just an unforced error. Stay alert, don't jump early, and give them free yardage.
That'd be a fire. I like that one, look. He holding it. He holding the ball, man. He got to do it. See you later. This is funny. I got to challenge myself by picking said teams. It's cool. definitely not hurt.
I'm an organic organism, ain't no ordinary organs in them. I can't afford any synonymy. That's why my flow is like a cinnamon tsunami with the lemongrass. Ooh, ooh. Let me know what you're gonna do. If you're gonna build, I'm Bobby. If not, then get it in a lobby. I got a lot to do. Ooh, I'ma watch what you're gonna do. If you're gonna build, I'm Bobby. If not, then chuck a deuce. You throwing off the vibe. Thank you.